I was walking down the street the other day looking to score a bag of weed, and this guy comes up to me and he says, "Excuse me, sir, but are you a born again Christian?" And I said, "Shit, yeah, isn't everybody? I mean, that's the easiest thing in the world, isn't it? You just say, I believe, and then you got eternal life. So, of course, yeah, I'm a born again Christian, baby." And so he let me loose. And I continue walking down the street, And it occurred to me, as I was getting high, that maybe there was a bit more to this whole Christianity deal than me and my boy were letting on to believe. Seems to me that if you're going to call yourself a Marxist, you got to do more than just cherry-pick a few quotes out of Das Kapital. You got to walk the walk. You can't call yourself a Marxist and trade stock. I mean, come on. That's not right. And it seemed to me that a lot of these Christians, they just call themselves Christians. But they can't really be Christians, can they? I mean, can all of them really be Christians? It doesn't seem possible. It seems like Jesus Christ was a revolutionary. But I look around at the mega church, I'm not seeing very many revolutionary types in the congregation. And the preacher, looking down at us, he ain't too revolutionary either, I mean, this guy's living in a 4,000 or 5,000 square foot house, 3-car garage, swimming pool. I'm thinking, man, Jesus Christ, he was the Son of God, right? He could have lived that way. As the Son of God, I think he could have scratched a few coins together. But he didn't do that. In fact, Jesus said to do some difficult things if you were going to call yourself a disciple of his. If the gospel's to be trusted at all. I seem to remember a quote. Let he who is without sin cast the first stone. And I was thinking back to the mega church, thinking, when was the last time I heard mega preacher say, let he who is without sin cast the first stone? I don't think he's ever said it. What he likes to do is say, believe and you shall have eternal bliss. And give me some money. And this doesn't seem really to be on task with what Jesus Christ was talking about. And then I was remembering too something about let the dead bury the dead. Jesus was telling this guy, look, if you're going to follow me, you start today, now. Don't make any excuses. You'd have to leave the world now and come and follow me now. I don't hear that message coming from mega preacher either. More like mega preacher saying, go out and get a good job in Jesus' name so you can give me some goddamn money. That's what I hear mega preacher saying. And everybody's just nodding their head. Oh, yeah, mega preacher. Who are these people, man? They can't really be serious about calling themselves Christians, can they? When Jesus Christ said to do stuff and you don't do the first thing that he said to do, none of it, how in the world do you call yourself a follower of somebody when you don't do the first thing they told you to do? Sell everything you have and give it to the poor. When was the last time I heard mega preacher tell me to sell everything I have and give it to the poor? He wouldn't have the guts to say something like that because people would just walk out, okay? Nobody's going to take that crap. Nobody wants to hear it. They want to hear about revelations. They want to hear about hellfire and brimstone for the non-believer. And what does 666 on the beast, what is that? And, you know, they just want to like it's some kind of jigsaw puzzle, you know? Like, oh, let's go hear some more riddles about revelations. And then we can sing Jesus Loves Me. And, you know, I mean, what kind of religion is that? Where the principal founder and teacher and prophet of the religion gets no airtime in the religion. That it's inconceivable. Judge not, lest ye be judged. You know, I know a lot of people who call themselves Christians, and all they do is judge people. How in the world does this square with being a disciple of Jesus Christ? I don't get it. Let he who is without the sin cast the first stone. Sell everything you have and give it to the poor. Judge not, lest ye be judged. Let the dead bury the dead. These people don't do any of that stuff. They don't even think about doing it. They're living, you know, in big houses, driving fancy cars. Then they go to church on Sunday with little Junior and little Missy. And, you know, and then the next day they're out screaming, hang them high at the next lynch mob. I mean, what the hell is going on with these people? And what kind of preachers are these, man? I mean, aren't these the preachers that Jesus was talking about? You know, if you lead them astray, you're going to be sorry. You know, it's worse to have been, you know, I don't know, never born at all than to lead one of these little ones astray. But, you know, these people must be leading us all astray because Jesus Christ was a revolutionary. He had it so bad, they killed him. Okay, they killed him. He was a revolutionary, and, well, what does governments do when revolutionaries get powerful? They kill them. That's exactly what happened. Jesus Christ died for our sins? Man, what a waste. Because we're sinning like he never died at all. We don't do anything he said to do. How in the hell do you call yourself a Christian, man, when you park in your car in your 2-3-car garage after passing by 10 homeless guys? You didn't sell everything you had and give it to the poor. You didn't let the dead bury the dead. You didn't give the man the shirt off your back. You didn't do any of it. So quit calling yourself a disciple of Jesus Christ when you don't do anything that he told you to do. Is that hard? Is that really hard to wrap your little mind around that Jesus was talking about some revolutionary shit and that you don't pay attention to any of the tough stuff that he told you to do? You don't belong in his circle if you don't walk the walk. And this is the editorialist for you.